I guess it was a story about, following your dreams and having a passion that's kind of irrefutable and unstoppable, and whatever obstacles get in your way, you still overcome them and realize your dream. But also live in reality too, in the way that he had to temper some of his appetite. He's a kid who's obsessed with football and wants to be a footballer, and his mother has other thoughts about giving him a few more opportunities in life and getting him a good education. And it's the struggle between that and then the Matt Busby character, I suppose, making his life as purposeful as it possibly can be, because he's got this sort of guilt about having survived when all those young footballers were killed on the plane, and trying to find a meaning to his life. And so they've all got a struggle, and they all sort of overcome that in some way. And it's, I mean, I'm making, I loathe describing films that I'm in, because you always end, it's so reductionist, isn't it? Sort of see the film really, and then, yeah. What's interesting is the people who've seen it who aren't connected, just have no appetite for football whatsoever, have got as much out of it as the people who are into football, that it's an allegory for so many other things in life. It's clearly, well, any good movie is that. It's not about the subject that it's, that or the place setting of the story. It's usually, it ripples out to mean and have resonances in all sorts of things, in areas of life. So, yeah, and I love that even a 4-year-old can sit and enjoy it and dance to the madness music and, yeah. And then my mum loved it. And so, no, it's good, it's a good one.
Right at the heart of this story is Georgie, this incredible little boy. Can you talk about the experience, particularly working with him?
Yeah, it was great. He's a first-timer, so that's always really exciting. And his major preoccupation, passion in life is football. And so you didn't really see his face very much. Saw the crown of his blonde hair, just always looking down, dribbling this ball around your feet, which I just, I mean, part of my life has been like that with my middle son. He's exactly the same. So I love that we're putting that up on screen. It's something I think so many people will be able to relate to. And he was great, very unpretentious, just sort of cracked on with it and got on with the other kids. It was a real group. I mean, it was very much a group effort. I know he's the central character, but it was very much, I think, through the support of all the others that he got to where he got to, and he felt that they got on very well. They were a good little team. Brian is, he's just got this great sort of roadmap of a face and a kind of, you can watch him for hours. He's very mesmeric as an actor, and I think I wish we saw more of that on screen. I think quite often sort of try and, yeah, anyway, I think he was terrific, and I can't imagine anyone else playing the part, actually. I thought it was just wonderful. I would say definitely say go to see it, irrespective of whether you're a football fan or not, because it definitely works on a few levels.